Well, hello and welcome back. We are continuing our series where we're looking at, sort of combining our Python and our SQL tutorials, and we're building a database synchronization script based on, it's written in Python. Now, since the last time, I do want to catch up a little bit. There are a couple of things that I, just so you know. So one of them is, we were looking at default functions. You know, you can either default as a value or a function. One of your defaults, and we basically said if it's a function, then if we have a parenthesis, open parenthesis, then we're going to assume there's a function in there. However, there is the key phrase current underscore timestamp, which actually is a function. And there may be some others, but this one I know I ran into, so go ahead and count that as a function. Another thing was, just for safety's sake, I went ahead and decided to wrap the column names in these little tick marks in case it is some sort of reserved word or something like that. I came across that in one of the things I was playing around with, so I figured it was probably best to do that. That being said, now, so what we've got is we've been able to come in and deal with our tables. The next thing we want to do is we're going to go with the table. We're going to see if the columns match up. So let's see, create missing tables. Let's just pause that for right now. So we'll come back to that later. And for now, what we want to do is we're going to go for in each, let's see, where do we do, find, here we go, missing tables. And now we're going to create one that's called missing columns. And basically, it's going to work the way as missing tables. So there's going to be a source and a target. And let's see, we had somewhere down here, we did missing tables. Here. And we'll just print them for now in case there are any. I don't think there will be because we should have everything going. And now we're going to have missing columns. And these table.columns are not in target. So this one's going to be a little more complicated. So for missing columns, what we're going to do is we're going to go through so for each table, and we're going to assume that they're not missing. So we actually don't need, well, I guess we do need it in both of them. That's a good question. Let's say, well, we do still need source and target. And did we call those? Oh, no. So we need actually this source. So we do missing columns. Here we go. We actually need dbc, which is our source, and db2 is our target. And let's actually do tables, which is going to be, let's just say it's source tables. So we're going to assume that they're all there at this point, and we'll see how that works out. So back up here. So we have, let's do this, db source, db destination, and tables. Tables list. And so missing columns. So now what we're going to do is, for row and tables list, and so now each one, this is going to be a table name, and so we're going to have to do a query. We'll just take that one, for row in there. We're going to return missing columns. And let's see, so this is going to be our column query. This will be our source column query. And let's see, in each one, yep, Well, actually, that could be our column query. And so we are going to, we need two cursors. Whoops. So let's do that. Let's go ahead and create these cursors real quick. So that's going to be cursor source is DB source. The destination is going to be DB dest. And so what we're going to do with each case, we're going to describe the table. So we're going to get two sets back. So we're going to do source and destination. Call query. Okay. And so we want source and we want destination. So now we're going to have source columns equals. We're going to have, we'll call it destination columns equals. And wait, that's not what we want. I'm sorry. We just want to execute them first. Execute the two, and then we're going to be source columns equals cursor source.factual. There we go. Destination columns equals destination fetch all. And now what we're going to do here is do something along these lines. So what we're going to do, so for column row in target destination columns, then for each one, let's see, so name is going to be equal to row zero, because that is where our names are for our columns. And if name is not in, so what we want to do, okay, so first we got to generate names. So let's call it source names equals this. And then for column row in source columns, then for each one of those source names dot append, see call row zero. So we're going to go into each of these. First, what we're going to do is we're going to build a list of the column names and the source. And then we're going to go through each one of the destinations, and we're going to say if the name is not in source names, this is call row. So if the column, if the name of the destination is not in the source, then we're going to do missing columns. And we're going to append the name, except for we're going to do a table, which is, let's do this for table. There we go. It's going to be table plus, and we're just going to do dot name. So this is going to give us all of the missing columns, and then we're going to run through and see how that works. Now, so right now, let's see if it even runs. Whoops, that's not the one I want to do. So we didn't get any mix, but let's go ahead and break one here. So let's go to our source. Let's see. So testing was our source, right? Let's see. Tutorial is our source. Okay. So local let's see. Is that right? Okay, so then local tutorial is our database. So let's go look here. Okay, so if we go here, let's get rid of a column somewhere. Like, it really doesn't matter, so let's just do with our address. Let's start with that. Let's get rid of our zip. So let's go in here, alter table, and we're going to delete this column. So we're going to drop column zip. And now what we should see is that should show up. And it does not. So let's go in here. Oh, let's see. These columns are not in the target. Okay, so we are. So now what we want to do is we're going to go missing columns. Oh. Did we do? Oh, no, that's right. So, we did this wrong. We want to do, the destination columns, and then we want to say anything that's in source. So this one says, if the name is not in the source names, so if the source data is not in the, let's do this, let's change this a little bit, just to make it less annoying. So here's the thing. So in this case, we're going from A to B. And so we're gonna say, let's look at all the columns in B. And then look at all the columns. And then for each of those, we're going to see, which is here. And then for each of those, we're going to say, for everything that's in A, we're going to say, hey, does that already exist? If it doesn't, then it's missing. And that should give us, here we go. Missing columns is not defined. Oh, it's columns. And so I bet now we'll see. There we go. So address.zip is not there. So we have gone through and we're now doing this. And so we can find this is, as we did before, this is, these columns are not in target. We can take the same thing and say these columns are not in source, just in case there's some extras. And all we do here is swap these two. So that's DBC. That's DB2. So what we'll get is, we should get through here, address.zip, but it's all fine the other way. And so that brings us to, now what do we do? So if we do this, where did that go? Here. So what we need to do in this case is say that we have a missing column, which is good, because what we can do is we can actually do this. How do we want to do this? This will be good. Let's just look at it this way. This won't give us a name, but what we can do is we could just say call row, and now we're going to see what the definition of that is. And here we see that, okay, so this is missing. And so all we need is a table name. So we probably want to do this a little differently. We're going to probably want to build our SQL right here and then go back to this and then create out our SQL, which will probably include the table and the name. So it would be something along like, let's do table SQL equals alter table plus name plus add column, oops, that's not name, that's table, plus name, plus, we'll do this, plus a type, which is call row, which we found before, is the type is one. So let's look at this for now. And then we'll print this. Let's print call row. There we go. And so now we're going to see, oops, we didn't print that, did we? Oh, yes, we did. Oh, my mistake. We want this to be table underscore SQL. Bam. So here we go. So now we're starting to see the start of our SQL, and we can see here basically, yeah, for this column. That sort of puts us run to the end of this one. So the next episode, we're going to come back and we're going to start building out that column SQL. And probably like we've seen before, where we built a table, we're going to have to, you know, essentially steal some of the same information. So we may do some sort of a, you know, abstract this out to a build column SQL, something along those lines. But I don't want to, you know, spoil it too much. So for now, go out there and have yourself a great day, a great week. And we will talk to you next time.